Praise the Lord, First Pentecostal Church, Saints of God, the greatest people in all the world. I'm honored to greet you tonight, especially. I'm very excited to talk about what we are going to be talking about tonight. But before I do, I wanted to, first of all, just commend you and applaud you for the way that you have handled what is, in my opinion, an unprecedented situation. No one of my generation has ever faced anything like this before. But I have been so blessed by observing you. It's been a joy to watch people genuinely display Christian hospitality. One of the things that, if there are positives that come out of this, which we know that there will be, because God has such a unique way of turning our negatives into positives. But already, I think we have had an incredible opportunity to not just go to church, not just attend church, although we're all very anxious for that, but we've had a wonderful opportunity to actually be the church. And I think that has been a very positive thing. And I've been blessed to watch you and observe you be the church, from the displays of your Christian hospitality, those that have prepared meals for many of our elders who have not been able to get out as they normally would, and taking meals to them on special occasions, and those that have been in and out of the hospital. And you've been so very kind to come alongside them. I use the word visit loosely, but visit them as much as we could while practicing social distancing and just taking care of them. And I applaud you for that. I've also been able to witness Christian generosity. I've had multiple people just send in random offerings or add to their normal giving and just ask us as a staff, you know who the needs are, please give this to somebody in need. And I thank you so very much for that. Your Christian character, we've had saints to attend funerals where we couldn't even get out of the car. You could only observe a graveside from a distance, but you wanted to be there. You did not want people that you love to suffer alone. And so you, although it's awkward to sit in a car and not be able to hug and touch and show the affection like we normally do, it's been wonderful to watch people adapt, change, and still show love and affection, even though we couldn't do it in the normal patterns that we typically would. So I have been able to watch that in person in a time when we've all been stressed out. It's uncomfortable for all of us, a lot of uncertainty. A lot of people agitated, aggravated, wanting answers and not certain if we're getting correct answers. But I have watched you be patient and be mild and let God be God and let God lead us and help us. And so I want you to know from your pastor, I genuinely applaud you. And I appreciate you when you couldn't go to church. I appreciate you genuinely being the church. We love you and we miss you. And I know that has been expressed to me many, many times. We are missing one another, which again is a good thing. I don't think that any of us will ever take church attendance for granted again. I don't even think that we'll take one another for granted again. We are ready to see one another. We're ready to be with one another. And that's the way it's supposed to be. Fellowship is a part of our apostolic Pentecostal experience. It was one of the unique characteristics of the first church, and it's most certainly still a characteristic of this church as well. So I have good news and then maybe not so good news. I don't think any of this is bad news. It would be wonderful if we could just go back to normal, by our definition of normal, which would be pre-COVID-19, having church like that. It would be wonderful if we could just go straight to that. Unfortunately, we will not be able to go back to that definition of normal. Our staff has met multiple times. We are doing our very best to follow our national guidelines, our state guidelines, trying to keep everybody safe, even visiting with medical personnel that are part of our local church and leaning on them and getting their insight. I don't believe there's going to be an ideal, perfect time for us to try to come back and have a physical service. We've been so very blessed to be able to have our online service, and I want to publicly thank those that have worked so diligently behind the scenes. Lexi Hales and Jessica Stanley and Ryan Swilley and Jordan Hewlett and others, and I know, forgive me when I start calling names, I'm going to forget someone, but they have worked so tirelessly, service after service, worked for hours, editing, putting videos together, tracing down frustrating glitches and problems, and thank you for your patience with us. This is not a perfect science, but we're trying to get there. Brother Hall, our music team, praise singers, musicians, service after service have just done an incredible job. So I am thankful that we have been able to have our online service together. I'm also thankful for the couple of drive-in services that we've been able to do. Took a lot of people to put that together. And they've gone so wonderfully. The Lord's blessed us with beautiful weather and just to see each other. Although we've been confined to our cars, we've been blessed, both online and drive-in service, that we have been blessed to feel the presence of God. And I have felt the word of the Lord so very strongly during this time. And I'm grateful to God for that. God has not left us. God goes exactly where we are and has a word for us. And has continually shown that. But I wanted to talk to you tonight rather than just in a preaching style. I wanted to explain to you as best I can what our plan is. And again, we know that this is not an ideal plan. This is not a perfect plan. But under the circumstances, we feel like it's the best of what we can do right now. So again, I know there's not a perfect time for us to come back. Many of you wished we could have had a physical service weeks ago. Others will think we should wait several more weeks, and I understand both of those. But we have decided, again, after counsel and seeking is the best help that we could, that this coming Sunday, May the 17th, we will be back in the building. That's the good news. We will be worshiping together. We will be having church together, and that is an exciting time. I know that God will be with us, and it will be wonderful just to have people back in the building. However, that does not equal normal church. There will be some guidelines that I'm going to outline for you tonight that I would earnestly ask you to follow as closely as we can. Again, I think there are some positives that we will draw from throughout this pandemic. I think one of them is the need for personal responsibility, the realization that I don't live in my world, we live in our world, and I need to be as aware of your needs as I am of my own. And so many of the guidelines that we are seeking to undertake are not just for you or me as an individual, but it's for the greater good of all of us. It's for the community. It's for the realization that we are a community of believers, and we want to keep everybody just as safe as we possibly can. Yes, without doubt, I believe that God's with us. I believe that God is our healer. I believe that God's going to protect us. I have no reservations about that. But I also believe that God expects us to do our due diligence. And so we're going to do that as a staff, as a church family. So, having said all of that, there are three phases. And please be aware, the dates that I will give you and even the guidelines of each phase are all fluid because this situation can change very quickly, either for better or for worse. So what I'm giving you tonight is the best guidelines that we can give with the information that we have available right now. So again, please remember this may, we may have to tweak this as we get into it, but we at least felt it was our responsibility to come up with a plan to get us back to having church in the building again. So we have three phases. Phase one begins this coming Sunday, May the 17th, and that will continue through the last Sunday of May, May the 31st. We will continue our online service. And at the outset of this, let me say, when I'm telling you that we are coming back to have a physical service, that does not mean that you have to be here. No, you are not sinning by not coming to the house of God. If you feel in any way that you're not comfortable, that it's too premature for you, or if you feel sick, or if you feel at risk, I encourage you. Thank God for this technology. Stay home. Worship with us online. I strongly recommend and encourage you to do that. Nobody's going to judge you for not being physically in the house of God. It's perfectly fine for you to worship online. But for those of us that feel safe and are not having health issues and are not necessarily at risk, we want to at least have as much church as we can. So we will continue online service as per normal. We will be limiting our physical attendance in the building to 50% of the capacity of our building. What we will be doing to accommodate that is we will be roping off every other pew. And so when you come into the building on Sunday morning, the pews that are roped off, we're asking you to please acknowledge that, please honor that, and sit on the rows that are accessible, and let's maintain as much social distancing as we can, as I'll talk about in a moment. Now, our first service on Sunday morning will begin at 8:30. It's 8:30 a.m. Sunday morning, and that is a service for those who are 65 years of age and older. And we're asking for it only to be that age group. We want you in the building first. We are disinfecting. We've cleaned carpets today and disinfected the sanctuary. We will have everything deep cleaned and disinfected. We will have ushers that will be standing at the front doors. They will have on masks. They will hold doors open. You won't have to touch anything at all coming into the building. We will have sanitation stations set up with hand sanitizers. We also have masks. If you want to wear a mask to church, that's perfectly fine. If you don't have one and need one, we will have those available here at our sanitation station here at the church. So that will be at 8:30 Sunday morning. And again, this is phase one, it's age 65 and above. That service will last for approximately 1 hour. And then when you exit the building, you will exit through the fellowship hall. You're welcome, if you want to practice social distancing and fellowship in the fellowship hall if you'd like to. We're going to do our best to have some light snacks available for you there. And then you'll be going out the south portico back to your cars. Again, you're more than welcome to stay in fellowship. There's no pressure, but we wanted those 65 and older to be here first so that you would feel safe. We want you to be able to have church as well. Our second service will begin at 10 a.m. And this is obviously open for all of the congregation, anybody who wants to attend church. That's at 10 a.m. Sunday morning. Now, we will not be opening the doors to the sanctuary until 15 minutes prior to service. We're doing that on purpose. It's hard not to fellowship, especially when you see one another. And so we're going to do our best to limit the exposure, the time that we even have to fellowship. So the doors will not be open until 8:15 Sunday morning for the first service and at 9:45 for the second service. Only the front doors will be opened. And that is where we want everyone to come through. We are not opening the entire building, only the sanctuary, only the front main entrance We're asking you, please don't go throughout the building. We don't want our building contaminated. And so we're doing our due diligence to make sure that doesn't happen. So we enter in through the main entrance. Again, ushers opening doors with masks on, sanitation station. You'll come into the sanctuary. Half of the pews will be roped off. We encourage you to maintain 6-foot rule of social distancing. We ask that households sit together as much as you possibly can. The crowd will not be sitting on their side of the building as they normally do. And so we want our children to sit with their parents. We want households to sit together. It will be difficult, but we are asking for no hugs, no handshaking. Please, it won't be normal, but at least we're back in the building. So please remember that this is not just about me or you, it's about all of us. So again, we're asking that households sit together. There will be no nursery, no Sunday school classes, no crew class, no crowd services for this first phase. Again, our trafficked areas are being disinfected. They're being deep cleaned, doing everything that we can to make sure that you are safe. We will not be having a choir at this time. We will still be limiting the number of people that are on the platform. There will not be a designated altar call as we are accustomed to. It would be quite difficult to do that and maintain social distancing. However, we do expect the Spirit of God to move in our service. We expect people to be touched. The Bible is very clear. As a matter of fact, in Acts 10, the Bible said that while Peter yet spake the words, the Holy Ghost fell on all of them that were attending there in the house of Cornelius. You can be anywhere in this building and the Holy Ghost will fall on you. I encourage us, we're going to worship, we're going to sing, we're going to dance, we're going to praise God, but we're going to do it in reason and keep everybody safe. So you will feel the presence of God right there at your pew, and you can enjoy that and worship, and we will all be safe. We will not be handing out a connection. We will not be taking up what we call a normal offering. We will not be passing the offering bags around. What we will do is have opportunity in the foyer for you to do online giving. We will also have our tithe boxes. We will move some of them into the foyer, and you'll have the ability to give as you're coming in or as you are going out. So we'll be posting all of this online. I know this is a lot of information to digest right now, but that's phase one. And again, that goes from this coming Sunday, May the 17th, through the last Sunday of the month, May the 31st. Hopefully, we can begin phase two the first Sunday in June, June the 7th, and that will go until June the 21st. Phase two, again, we will continue online service as per normal. We will, again, limit the capacity of our sanctuary to 50%. The only real change is we will not have an 8:30 a.m. service. We will only have one 10 a.m. service. We are hoping by June that it will be safe for those 65 and above to attend the regular service. Again, we will be watching that closely. If we need to change and adapt, we will do so. But at least these are guidelines, to at least a place to begin. So 10 a.m. beginning on June the 7th is phase two. That is open to all the congregation. One of the things I failed to mention in phase one that we will be doing in phase two, we will be taking people's temperature at the door. If by chance you are running a fever, if you already know it, please stay home. There's no condemnation for that, nor is there a commendation for coming to church with a fever. We want you to stay home. If you come to church with a fever, we will ask that you not enter the building. And that's just standard procedure for any public building or public place. So again, please be aware of that. That will not be an intrusive thing, but it is something that we will be doing just to keep all of us safe. So we will be taking temperature at the door in phase one and phase two. We will still be asking that we maintain the social guidelines of the 6-foot rule, household sitting together, no hugging, no handshaking. It is our hope that we will begin that first week of June having our midweek service again. And so hopefully that following, that would be the 10th of June, we will be able to have our midweek service as per normal at 7 o'clock, as well as the crowd. And we will be using all of these same precautions in the crowd. We will not have a nursery again. We will not be doing Sunday school, nor will we be having the crew. And I know that doesn't seem quite fair to the crew if we get to have crowd and not the crew. But I don't think that we can in any way enforce or accommodate social distancing and a 6-foot rule with our crew. I think that would be quite impossible. So we will just lean on Sister Jessica and Brother Jeff and all of their staff to keep that going. And again, they've done such an incredible job with our online crew. So phase two will still, we will have no nursery available. There will be no Sunday school and no crew. Again, we will continue to disinfect. We will continue to do deep cleaning. Our ushers, and we will only be using ushers that are 60 or under 65 years of age. They will be opening doors. They will have on masks. We will maintain our sanitation stations here in the foyer as we did in phase number one. We will have masks available. If anyone does not have one and you would like one, we will not be having our choir. It will be our praise singers and musicians. And again, in phase two, unfortunately, we will not be having a pronounced altar call. We will be, again, believing God for a great outpouring of the Holy Ghost. We will not be taking up a regular offering, but you will have an opportunity to give online, as well as our tithe boxes that will be in the foyer. So again, I know that this is not ideal. It's not exactly what any of us want, but at the moment, I feel like it's the best we can do to keep everybody safe, but get us back together. I think it's important for us to see one another. I want to commend all of you. Many of you I've talked to, and you're doing your own private family devotions in your homes, Bible studies that have just been tremendous, and I think that's fantastic. I think one of the great positives is our families getting reconnected, as it were, and getting involved in one another's lives. So you've done an incredible job of that, and I am very grateful to the Lord for that. So again, this is not ideal, but it is bringing us back together. We'll be able to see one another, worship together, enjoy God together, and also be aware that this too shall pass in Jesus' name. So beginning June the 28th, we'll begin our phase three, which we hope will be our final phase that will move us back into what we're considering normal or pre-COVID-19 guidelines. Again, these are approximate dates, June the 28th through July the 12th. That's phase three. We will continue online service, continue at 50% capacity of our sanctuary, continue taking temperatures at the door, continue the 6-foot rule. By that time, we should be back to our normal midweek service at 7. And this time, phase three will include the crew and the crowd. So we will be back to normal in all of those things. There will be no nursery, no Sunday school. It was our great plan and hope and desire that we could begin our life groups in the month of June, but that's looking pretty impossible. Possibly by mid-July, if not, we'll begin those in August. I'm very excited about those, especially after what we've all been through. I think it's going to be very important that we meet together in our own age groups, that we rub shoulders together. We're all going to have some testimonies and some stories to tell. But it's also going to be wonderful to reconnect and to be aware that we've, even when we felt isolated and alone, we were never really alone. That there were others that were going through exactly what we were going through. But as we begin our life groups, I think the timing is going to be very good. It's going to be very supportive of one another, and we're going to need that because we have come through a very difficult time. I'm sorry, let me rephrase that. We are still in the middle of a very difficult time, but we are believing there will come a day when we can say that we have come through a very difficult time and God was faithful. and God absolutely kept us. We're in the middle of it now, but we will come through it. So again, phase three, no regular offering, no regular altar call as per normal. It'll be online giving and Dropbox giving. So that's phase one, phase two, phase three, and hopefully by the end of phase three, there are no masks, there are no having to open doors, and we're back to normal and loving God together. But please do be aware, these are fluid things. This is just an outline, a guideline, doing our best to project, but the dates of each phase of this plan are definitely subject to change. Again, I just want to underline and remind, if you are running a temperature, we will ask you, please don't come in the building. Please respect everyone else. Another thing that we'll be trying to watch very closely is having a limited number of people at any given time in our restrooms. We are going to be very cognizant, aware of time. As we've done in our drive-in services, we're going to do our very best to hold our services to an hour and 15 minutes max. We're going to watch that very closely. So far, the only real problem we've had with trying to hold it there is this long-winded preacher that gets wound up every once in a while. But we're going to try to harness that some and be very much aware of the time. But that is something that we will be watching very closely. Ushers will be assisting us in that. We don't want crowds in the restroom at any given time, so we will be limiting that. If possible, drink water before you get here, and don't use the water fountain if you can at all. Make it without it. I think that would be best. And again, please remember now, especially in phase one, that only the front entrances, the foyer area, and the main sanctuary, that's the only parts of the building that will be open to all of us. The only exception to that is the fellowship hall for those that are 65 and above for their 8:30 a.m. service. So I understand, again, this is a lot of information to digest at one moment, but I just wanted to take this time on this Wednesday evening to just take our time, share with you what is our plan for reopening and getting us back into at least some semblance of normal. We'll be posting all of this on all of our social media outlets. We'll be sending text out with all of this information. Spread the word. There are people in our church who do not do social media, so please let them know what the days and weeks ahead will hold. Again, the good news is we'll be worshiping together. The not so good is it won't be exactly what we want, but again, we can do it. We've obviously had to do worse than that these last several weeks. So Sunday's going to be an incredible day. 8:30 a.m. Sunday morning for those 65 and above. I can't wait to see you. We're going to have a great time in the Lord. And then at 10 a.m. Sunday morning, everybody's welcome. Everybody is encouraged to be here, with the exception of those who are sick or feel in any way that you are at risk. There is no pressure to be in this building. But if you're ready and you feel comfortable and feel safe, then we obviously want you to be here. We love you. We are praying for you. We're here for you. I know all of these things have all been said, but just want to underline them. Our staff is always available to you. And again, look forward to seeing you on Sunday. God bless you and have a wonderful evening.